मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द 17th पार्ट ऑफ सर्किल। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ अ कर्व व्हेन इट्स मिड पॉइंट इज गिवन एंड डायरेक्टर सर्किल एंड पोजिशन ऑफ टू सर्किल्स ऑन ए प्लेन। फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ अ कर्व व्हेन इट्स मिड पॉइंट गिवन। स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट थ्योरम। PX1Y1 इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ द कर्व AB ऑफ ए सर्किल S equal to 0. S equal to 0 stand for general circle. Then the equation of AB is S1 is equal to S double 1. S1 equal to S double 1. Notation. S1 means XX1 plus YY1 plus G times of X plus X1 plus F times of Y plus Y1 plus C. S double 1 means X1 square plus Y1 square plus 2GX1 plus 2FY1 plus C. So here it one note is AB is not diameter. Okay. So except that case. This is the diagram. The center of the circle says C minus G comma minus F. This is chord AB. Here what is this? This is the midpoint, say M. P given, okay, P. P is given as X1 comma Y1. So, now we want to find the equation of AB. Only one point on AB is there. We need its slope to find its equation, or one more point on that line to find its equation. Slope we can find logically. Important note. In any circle, from center and midpoint of chord are joined. Automatically, this line segment become the perpendicular to AB. From center of a circle, if a perpendicular dropped on a chord, it bisects it. And its converse also true. Its converse saying that if P is the midpoint, and CP will be perpendicular to AB. That's why, now I can say CP perpendicular to AB, C coordinates are there, P coordinates are there, I can find slope of CP, by using that I can find slope of AB, and point is there, by using point slope form, I can find the equation of AB, that is plan. Okay. Slope of CP. Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1, Y1, minus half minus plus F by X1, minus half minus plus G. This is the slope of CP. Slope of AB. AB is equal to minus 1 by slope of CP. Reason is CP is perpendicular to AB. Okay, so directly I want to write slope of AB, reverse, minus half x1 plus g by y1 plus f. Now I want to find equation of AB by using point slope form. Equation of AB. Point slope form. Y minus Y1 equal to slope M times of X minus X1 minus X1 plus G by Y1 plus F times of X minus X1. So this is nothing but Y minus Y1 into Y1 plus F plus X plus G into X minus X1 equal to 0. Now we need simplify now. YY1 plus YF minus Y1 square minus Y1F plus XX1 minus X1 square plus GX, okay, minus GX1 equal to 0. Okay, students, now I want to write now what is here XX1 plus YY1 plus XX1 plus YY1, yeah, plus YF plus GX is equal to X1 square plus Y1 square, okay, minus Y1 means plus Y1, yeah, somewhere this is not a Y1, I think FY1 plus GX1. So actually what you want, S1 equal to S double 1 you want. XX1 as it is, प्लस वाई वाई वन एज इट इज, वाई एफ प्लस जी एक्स प्लस जी एक्स वन प्लस एफ वाई वन ओके प्लस सी इक्वल टू एक्स वन स्क्वायर प्लस वाई वन स्क्वायर प्लस वाई वन एफ प्लस जी वन एक्स वन. नाउ व्हाट आई एडेड है जी एक्स वन एडेड बोथ साइड एड एफ वाई वन एडेड प्लस सी एडेड. नाउ आई वांट सिंप्लीफाई दिस. ऑब्जर्व हियर एक्स एक्स वन प्लस वाई वाई वन प्लस सी जी एक्स वन या जी एक्स जी टाइम्स ऑफ एक्स प्लस एक्स वन प्लस एफ टाइम्स ऑफ वाई प्लस वाई वन प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू एक्स वन स्क्वायर प्लस वाई वन स्क्वायर जी एक्स वन टू जी एक्स वन प्लस टू एफ वाई वन प्लस सी. सो दैट इज वाट इज दिस नाना एस वन इक्वल टू एस डबल वन आर एस वन माइनस एस डबल वन इक्वल जीरो इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ द कार्ड ए बी. ओके ऑब्जर्व हियर ए सर्कुलर इक्वेशन इज गिवेन मिड पॉइंट कार्ड कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर गिवेन वी वांट फाइंड इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस बाय यूजिंग दिस फार्मूला यू कैन फाइंड दैट फार्मूला आर यू कैन फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस वन विदाउट यूजिंग दैट फार्मूला. सर्कुलर इक्वेशन गिवेन मींस यू कैन सेंटर यू कैन फाइंड फॉर एग्जांपल टू कामा थ्री कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ मिड पॉइंट ऑफ कार्ड इज गिवन एज सम 7, 9 ओके जस्ट यू वांट फाइंड इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस वन पॉइंट इज देयर वी वांट स्लोप फाइंड स्लोप ऑफ ओपी. From that you can find slope of line segment using this point and that slope directly you can find the equation of the curve without using any formula. Important note students, some books instead of S1 they are giving T, instead of S1 they are giving S1. Don't confuse. Okay, S1 stand for S1, T equal S1 also treat as equation of the curve. Okay students, one important note. Just now one theorem is completed, no? This is a circle. Midpoint of chord is given. How to find equation of that chord? That is S1 is equal to S double 1. Okay, this is given as P X1 Y1. Actually, through this midpoint, you can draw infinitely many chords. Infinitely many chords you can. Okay. So, what this note saying that? The chord bisected at P X1 Y1 is the farthest from the center among all the chords passing through P. So all these all are passing through P only. For all these chords P is not midpoint. For only one chord P is midpoint. That chord only farthest distance from the center. Understood? For example, this is center of the circle. Find this distance. This is the distance from this chord to center. So our card is this, our card is this one, this one, this, see, observe, this length is more than this, understood? That means from this point we can draw infinite many cards. For all those cards P is not midpoint. So for card for which P is midpoint, that card is farthest from center. Okay, one more important thing is, means which card is passing through that P or for which chord the P becomes the midpoint, that chord length only minimum. Okay, observe here man. So here this is the circle. Yeah, this is one of the chord, so that this is the P is the midpoint. P is the midpoint. So this is another chord. P is not midpoint. This is center, C. Observe, already if you join this P and C automatically perpendicular. So I can say this is the distance from center to this chord. So this is another chord. We need to draw perpendicular. Compare this line segment and this. So in this right triangle, this becomes hypotenuse. This only greater than this. I mean this distance only more. Understood? That's why the chord bisected at P X1 Y1 is the farthest from the center among all chords which are passes through P. Okay. What is the next one? Also, such chord length is minimum. Such chord means this chord length is minimum. Means compare this chord length and this chord length. This chord length is minimum automatically. Okay, students, two example problem. So, second one is interesting one. First one, find the equation of the chord of the circle x square plus y square equal to 9 whose middle point is 1 comma minus 2. First one. This chord equation one find its midpoint is given. What is the midpoint here? 1 comma minus 2. p is given, circular equation is given, x square plus y square minus 9 equal to 0. Directly means we are using formula. What is the formula? S1 minus S11 equal to 0. S1 is not XX1. XX1 means X, YY1 minus 2Y. Okay, so directly minus 9 minus, yeah, S11 is X1 square plus Y1 square plus 2GX1 plus 2F1, right, plus C. Okay, X1 square means 1 plus 4 minus 9 equal to 0. Or X minus 2 minus 9. This is what, nana, 5 minus 4 plus 4 equal to 0. Finally, x minus 2y minus 5 equal to 0 is the equation of such code. Okay, you don't want to use the formula. So, also you can find another solution. Okay, center is what, 0 comma 0. First of all, find the slope of CP. CP slope equal to minus 2 minus 0 by 1 minus 0, that is equal to minus 2. Automatically slope of AB becomes 2. Slope of AB equal to 2, sorry, 1 by 2. Slope of AB equal to 1 by 2. So equation of AB, y minus y1 equal to m, m means 1 by 2, into x minus x1. So 2y plus 4 equal to x minus 1, or x minus 2y minus 5 equal to 0. Or with using formula or without using formula, you can find the equation of a chord. Okay, students, second problem, interesting problem. A variable chord is drawn through the origin. Don't confuse the center and origin. Origin means 0, 0 on the coordinate plane. Center means center of the circle. Origin to the circle x square plus y square minus 2ax equal to 0. Find the locus of centers of the circles drawn on this chord as diameter. Okay. So x square plus y square minus 2ax equal to 0. This is passing through 0, 0. But I want to draw the rough sketch of the given circle. The rough sketch of given circle is this. Okay, passing through 0, 0 and also intersecting x-axis at a, 0. This is a, 0. Okay, now the question is, a variable chord is drawn through the origin. Through this origin, you can draw incremental many chords. One chord is drawn. This chord is taken as a diameter, a circle is constructed. Automatically, this becomes its midpoint. Say that is h, k. Similarly, another chord is drawn. This is another chord through origin. This is taken as diameter, another circle is constructed. Point of this chord being the center of the circle. Now, the question is, what is the locus of this point? It means, what rule followed by all the centers? Locus equation should find. So, what is nana? This is the chord for given circle. For that required locus, one of the point on the required locus become the midpoint of the chord. So by using midpoint of this chord, I can find equation of this straight line. The equation is passing through 0, 0. From there, we will get the relationship between h, k. Say this is p. Let p equal to h, k be a point on required locus. Understood. So, what is nana? What is the equation? Say this is O. So, this is some K. But the equation of OK, that is number S1 minus S11 equal 0. Because this is chord, that too, this is the midpoint. Equation of OK. Directly, I want to find equation is S minus S11. S1 minus S11. So, what is the circular equation here? X square plus Y square minus 2AX. Yeah, equal to 0. XX1 plus YY1 minus 8 times of X plus X1 equal to 0. That is S1. Okay, yeah, instead of X1, I should add HX plus KY. Okay, Ranana? Yeah, minus A times of X plus H. Okay, minus S double 1 means X1 square means H square plus K square minus 2AH equal to 0. This is the equation of OK, but this straight line is passing through origin. means 0 comma 0 is a point on this straight line. Means instead of x you can write 0, instead of y you can write 0 here. So, but this line passing through 0 comma 0. So what happened, Nana? Say this is equation number 1. So I want to write here. So 1 becomes 0, 0, minus a h, minus bracket, h square, plus k square, minus 2h, equal to 0. Or minus h square, minus k square, plus 2ah, okay, minus ah, equal to 0. Or h square plus k square minus ah equal to 0. Now I want to generalize. Instead of h, I want to write x. Instead of k, I want to write y to find the locus equation. Therefore, locus equation, I will write here. Therefore, locus equation, x square plus y square minus ax equal to 0. This is the locus equation. Okay, now I want to explain another method to find the locus equation of P. Observe here, P is the midpoint. See here, Q is the midpoint of the chord. P is one of the midpoint of the chord, Q is another midpoint. Okay, so now I want to explain an alternate method to find the solution. Actually here to a comma 0, not correct, Nana, 2a comma 0, put y equal to 0. What happened? X square minus 2ax equal 0 means x is equal 0 or x is equal to a. X equal 0 or x is equal to a. So this is 2a comma 0, leave it. Now automatically center is here a comma 0, center of the circle a comma 0, find it, minus g comma minus f, a comma 0. Now this is center, from center to midpoint of the chord is joined, automatically it is perpendicular. Means this is a right angle triangle. Similarly, this is midpoint of chord. So join this. This is perpendicular. So what about this? Another right triangle. How this midpoint of the chord is moving? Should identify first. Observe here. This right triangle and this right triangle means the midpoint of the chord is moving just like circular. So that for that circle, this is the diameter, because angle is semicircle 90 degree. O, this is say center. OC, OC is the diameter of the required circle. Here, once P, Nana, here, Q, P is the midpoint of chord, okay, Q is the midpoint of chord, some OL, okay, now you want to find what is the rule followed by all those midpoints. Observe here, for all those chords, OC is fixed here, OC fixed, so OC making 90 degree at this point, OC make 90 degree point, so the all those points will form a circle, for that circle, OC become diameter. Okay, so OC means what, Nana? OC is equal to A only. Radius of the circle becomes what? A by 2. Required circle radius is A by 2. Center means here, somewhere here, midpoint of this. A by 2 comma 0. Center is A by 2 comma 0. So, required circle center is A by 2 comma 0 and radius is A by 2. So, we can find its equation. That is the required locus equation. So, locus equation. X minus A by 2 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square equal to a by 2 whole square. X minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. So simplify this. X square plus a square by 4 minus ax minus ax plus y square equal to what happened here? A square by 4. Here a square by a square cancelled. What you got? X square plus y square minus ax equal 0. This is the locus equation of the point P, which is the midpoint of chord. Okay. Next concept, director circle. Director circle. What is meant by director circle? The definition is given. The locus of the point of intersection of two perpendicular tangents to a given circle is known as its director circle. Students, locus concept is very, very, very important. Okay, so you want to solve difficult problems. All the difficult problems are involving the concept of locus only. Okay, here also, directed circle means the locus of point of intersection of two perpendicular tangents to a given circle. Given circle, if circle is given, for that circle, we can find directed circle. How to find, what is the definition? Observe here. This is the a circle.
Now I want to find its directed circle. According to definition, the directed circle is the locus of the point of intersection of two perpendicular tangents to the given circle only. Directed circle means, for example, draw one tangent. Now we want to draw another tangent to the same circle so that there is perpendicular to this. For example, this is such tangent. These two are perpendicular. This point is required point for us. So through this point also we can draw another tangent. Perpendicular. This is our required point for us. So like draw another tangent. So draw another perpendicular to this. This is required point. So what is the locus? Locus of all those points. That is called the directed circle for given circle. See, the locus of the point of intersection of two perpendicular tangents to the given circle is known as its directed circle. Understood? This is given circle. This tangent and this tangents are perpendicular and here they are meeting. These two tangents are perpendicular. Here they are meeting. These two are two perpendicular tangents, they are meeting here. The point of intersection of all such tangents, you can draw infinitely many pairs of perpendicular tangents. So all those points will form a circle. That circle is called directed circle of given circle. Definition. But how to find equation of directed circle? Okay, see here. Equation of directed circle for x square plus y square equal to r square. Basic circle or x square plus y square equal to 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal 0. For that circle also you can find equation of directed circle. Just with the basic circle I want to find its directed circle. Okay, now observe here, diagram important here. This is a given circle. Center is 0, 0. Okay, here only I want to explain something. This is the center of the given circle. This is tangent, means point of tangency and center joint, that is perpendicular. This tangent and this tangent are perpendicular. So this is point of tangency. From center and that point joint, again that is perpendicular. Okay. Already these two tangents are perpendicular by the definition. See, in this quadrilateral, three angles are 90 means automatically fourth angle also 90 degree. Okay. So this is become a rectangle first. Next, observe. This is radius, this is radius. Two adjacent sides of rectangle are equal, so it is become a square. So this is a square. Means your directed circle. Your directed circle is the one of the vertex of the square. Similarly, here also. For this also, you get another square. Okay. So what happened? The locus is nothing but a corner of the square formed by this radii and this radii and this tangent segment and this tangent segment. One more important thing. This length is nothing but root 2 times of radius only. Okay, this right angle triangle, no? That to the square, all sides are equal. This is r, this is r. This is R, this is R, this is R. Hypotenuse, root 2 R. Means what happened? One of the points is taken as P here. So what is the nana? CP equal to root 2 R. Understood? Means the directed circle, any point on the directed circle is root 2 times of radius of the circle. That is important observation. So this is our directed circle now. What is the radius of the circle? Concentric circles only. Okay. What is the radius of this circle? R. What is the radius of the resulting circle? Root 2 R. This should be root 2 R. So, capital R equal to root 2 R. What is the center of the required circle? What is the center of the given circle? That only the center of the required directed circle. Because they are concentric circles. Center is 0, 0. Center is there, radius is there. You can find equation. By using standard form of a circle. Equation of directed circle. X minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square equal root 2 r whole square. That is x square plus y square equal 2 r square. x square plus y square 2r square is the directed circle for this circle. x square plus y square equal to r square. Similar way, you can find the equation of directed circle for general circle also. So this explanation is important, Nana. Students, next concept important. Relative positions of two circles on a plane. Two circles are given on a plane. Assume that two are different circles. Say first circle is C1 equal to its center is O1, radius is R1. Second circle is center is O2 and radius is R2. D is taken as distance between their centers. Distance between their centers. Observe here. Two circles are given on a plane. So the circle's position on the plane. I want to show the position of those two circles on the plane. See, this is the first position. This may be the position of the circles. This may be the position of the circles. Two circles with different radii are given on a plane. There exist five possibilities. This, or this, or this, or this, or this. They are not touch each other. They are touch each other. Or you can say they are tangent to each other. Tangent to each other. They are intersect to each other. They are tangent to each other. Tangent to each other. Difference? Tangent to each other externally. Tangent is internally. Okay. One circle is entirely inside. Two different circles are given in a plane. Okay. There exist five possibilities. Means among these five, any one of the situation hold. Okay. Now I want to find the relationship between D and R1 and R2 from all these situations. Observe here. One important note, already we learned in previous class, that is, if two circles touch each other internally or externally, the point of tangency and their centers are collinear, important. Proof of everything is completed already. Two circles touch each other internally or externally, the point of tangency and their centers are collinear. Okay. See here, this is center of the first circle, center of the second circle, join, this is D. So what is the, here Nana, D is greater than R1 plus R2. D is greater than R1 plus R2. D, R1 plus R2, D is greater than R1 plus R2. If any situation, if R1 and R2 are representing radii of two different circles, D is the distance between their centers, if D greater than R1 plus R2, directly you can say that this is the position of the circles. See here D equal to R1 plus R2. This is interesting one. This is D, center of the first circle and center of the second circle. This is D intersecting, no? Say if you join this, this becomes radius of the one circle, say R1. This is radius of the second circle, say R2. So it form a triangle. Sum of two sides of triangle greater than third side concept, R1 plus R2 greater than D. In this situation, R1 plus R2 greater than D. Observe here, this is another interesting one. This is point of tangency. Center of the smaller circle, center of the bigger circle. Already explained, these three are collinear. You can verify proof from your old class notebooks. Okay, this is the distance between their centers D. Here D equal to this radius minus this. This is radius of the bigger circle minus radius of smaller circle gives the distance between centers. So D equal to mod of R1 minus R2. Because you don't know R1 is greater R2, not mentioned here. So this is another interesting nana. This is center of the circle, center of the another circle. This is nothing but D now. This is nothing but D. So extend. So this is nothing but total length, nothing but radius of the one of the circle, say R1. From R, if you remove the radius of the smaller circle, what will get the value is this plus this. That's why this value mod, this value is greater than D. Okay, so mod of R1 minus R2 greater than D, then one circle is entirely inside the another circle. So this is the relationship between D and R1 and R2. Okay students, next concept, common tangent. Tangent concept completed. How to find equation of tangent of a circle and their applications, that they completed. Common tangent concept. Common tangent. See here, this is the circle and this is the tangent. Now you can say L is the tangent to the circle. This is called point of tangents. Sometimes this line may be tangent to more than one circle. So here another circle is given, here another circle is given, here another circle is given. Say this is C1, C2, C3, C4, like that. Now we can say that L is the common tangent for all these four circles. Common tangent. A line is tangent to more than one circle. Such line is called common tangent. Okay. There are two types common tangents. One is direct common tangent. Direct common tangent. Second one is indirect common tangent or transverse common tangent. Direct common tangent, indirect common tangent or transversal common tangent. Transverse common tangent. Okay, now I want to explain what is a direct common tangent and indirect common tangent. Okay, with respect to two circles, I want to define direct common tangents and indirect common tangent. If two circles are same side of the common tangent, then that common tangent is named by direct common tangent. Two circles are same side of the tangent. So these two circles, or this is tangent for both the circles, two circles are same side of the tangent. Such situation, the tangent is called direct common tangent. One. So if circles are either side of the common tangent, circles are either side of the common tangent, then this tangent is called indirect common tangent for these two circles, or transversal common tangent for those two circles. So in my diagram, L is direct common tangent for C1, C2, C3. For these two circles, this is indirect. For these two circles, this is indirect. For these two circles, that is indirect common tangent. Okay. Direct common tangent, indirect common tangent. Concept completed. Now, two circles are given on a plane. Okay, how many tangents you can draw for those two circles depend upon their positions. Understood? If two circles are given on a plane, we want draw common tangents for the two circles. Number of common tangents depend upon their positions. For example, in first situation, what the first situation? D greater than R1 plus R2 situation. We can draw four common tangents. See, this is one common tangent. This is another common tangent. So this is another common tangent. See, this is another common tangent. Four common tangents. Among four, two are direct. This is direct common tangent. This is direct common tangent. This is transversal common tangent. This is another transversal common tangent. Means two direct and two indirect in this situation. Okay, here. In this situation, you can draw only three common tangents. This is one common tangent called direct because circles are same side. No? This is another common tangent. That also direct. This is another common tangent, indirect. So in this situation where D equal R1 plus R2 situation, we can draw three common tangents. Among three, two are direct, one is indirect. Here. In this situation, we can draw only two common tangents. Those two are direct. So in this situation, we can draw only one common tangent. That is direct. In this situation, we can't draw any common tangent. C1 is a circle whose center is O and radius is capital R. C2 is another circle whose center is O2 and radius is small r. Okay. Position of circles. Condition. D is greater than R1 plus R2. So I can write capital R plus small r. Okay, no problem. Number of common tangents, 4. 2 direct, 2 indirect. Okay. Next position, touch each other. 3. Position D equal to R plus capital R plus small r. 3 you can. 2 direct, 1 indirect. Next situation, intersect each other. This is one, second one. 2. What is the result done here? R1 capital R plus small r greater than D. We can draw 2. 2 are direct, no indirect. Only one. In this situation, what is the meaning, Nana? D equal to cap R minus mod of capital R minus small r. How many? Only one. What is that? Direct. No indirect. Another situation. All you discussed the situation. What is that? Capital R minus small r mod is greater than distance between centers. In this case, no common tangents. Okay, students, this is also important concept for us. How to construct a direct common tangent for two circles? How to construct indirect common tangent for two circles? How to find length of direct common tangent? These three are important. So, first of all, construction of direct common tangent. Okay, so I want to take two circles. Say, first circle is equal, center is O. Radius is capital R. Second circle is taken as center is O dash and radius is small r. My assumption is capital R is greater than small r. Such a way that two circles are taken. Now I want to explain how to construct a direct common tangent. Important. First of all, construct these two circles. This is one circle. This is another circle. So what happened, Anna? This is the center of the first circle, say O, this is O dash. This is capital R and this is small r. Step 1, join their centers with this line segment as a diameter, draw a circle. You know everything. If a line segment is given, we want to draw a circle so that this is the diameter. It means you need to draw its perpendicular bisector. So this becomes the midpoint of the line segment. No, taking this one as center, this one as radius, you can draw a circle. For that circle, that is the diameter. Like that, construct a circle with OO dash as a diameter. Okay. Next step is, with the bigger circle, center as a center and capital R minus small r as a radius, draw another circle which is concentric with this. Step 2, with O as center, capital R minus small r as a radius, construct a circle. This is such circle. Let the circle intersect the previously constructed circle at P and Q. Join OP and extend. Join OQ and extend. Those two extensions intersect the given or original circle at A and B. What is step 1, Nana? With OO dash diameter, draw a circle. Step 2, with O as center, bigger circle center as a center, that is important. And radius capital R minus small r, draw a circle. Third step, which intersect the firstly constructed circle at P and Q. Next step. So join OP and extend. Join OQ and extend. The extensions will meet the original circles at A and B. Those two are important point for us. Next step. Next step. Through O dash, draw a line parallel to OA. Through O dash, draw a line parallel to OA. Let this meet the original circle at some K. Similarly, through O dash, draw a line parallel to OB. It intersects the original circle at L. Now, interesting step is join A and K. Join A and K and extend. Join B and L and extend. Those two are only the required common tangents. Construction of direct common tangent. I constructed. But we need to prove. How can you conclude that these two red lines are tangents for the given two circles? How to prove? Observe here. Plan. This is radius of the given circle. A line is passing through A. If here 90 degree, according to basic theorem, you can say that this is tangent to this circle only. Okay, a line drawn through end point of radius and perpendicular to it, that line is become the tangent only. So our plan is to prove this angle is 90 degree. Enough. Here also, if this angle is 90 degree, then you conclude that this is tangent smaller. So this becomes the common tangent to for both the circles. Like that, here 90, 90. That is our plan. For that, what I am doing? One more construction. Join PO dash. Join PO dash. Last construction. Join PO dash. Observe all of you. In a circle, if this is diameter, then angle in semicircle is 90 degree. Basic property of a circle. Angle in semicircle is 90 degree. Observe here. Observe here. This is the diameter for constructed circle. So means what happened here? Angle should be 90 degree. Angle OPO dash. OPO dash should be 90 degree. The reason is angle in semicircle is 90 degree. The circle is dotted circle. Observe here. Diameter no? 90 degree. And this is extended line only, no? Extended line. That's why here also 90 degree only. Linear pair. That is what the meaning of O dash PA. O dash PA is 90 degree. In this quadrilateral, one angle is I got 90. If I prove it is a parallelogram, all our 90s and we become rectangle only. That is plan. Now I want to prove that it is a parallelogram. Understood? What happened, Anna? In this quadrilateral, one corner angle you got 90 degree. If it is parallelogram, this becomes 90, this becomes 90, this becomes 90, rectangle, everything will complete. So, if two line segments are equal and parallel, if two line segments are equal and parallel, that line drawn their corresponding endpoints also equal and parallel, and it will form a parallelogram. That is a property of a parallelogram. Two line segments are equal and parallel. The line drawn their corresponding endpoints also equal and parallel. So it will form a parallelogram. My plan is PA already parallel to O dash K only. No, that's why you constructed. No, O dash K is parallel to OA only. So already PA parallel to O dash K already. It is better to prove that length of PA equal to length of O dash K. Then it became a parallelogram. Corner angle 90. So all our 90s should be rectangle. So here become 90, here become 90. Then I can conclude that there is a direct common tangent. No plan is PA equal to O dash K. Okay. What is his total length? Capital R. So PA, I will write here. PA equal to OA minus OP. OA means capital R. OP means radius of the constructed circle. Capital R minus small r. Capital R, R get cancelled. PA equal to small r. This is small r. PA small r. So what is this? Smaller and radius are smaller circle. So these two line segments are equal now. Already parallel. So it is a parallelogram. One angle is 90 degree. Rectangle. This is 90. This is 90. So now I can say that AK is the common tangent for these two circles. That too, dead common tangent. Similarly, you can prove that this is also dead common tangent. Okay. Now, interesting thing is, I want find AK length. AK length I want. AK length. AK. That is said to be the length of the direct common tangent. For example, here two circles are given. So this is a direct common tangent. Line, no, you can't find length. It's length. But this length is treated as length of the direct common tangent, or you can call length of the direct common tangent segment. Okay, now I want find the length of AK. Interesting. So this is now only proved. No, this is rectangle. So AK nothing but PO dash. So it is enough to find what is the length of PO dash. I want find AK. AK nothing but PO dash. It is enough to find length of PO dash. Okay, that is nothing but the length of the tangent segment. So in this right triangle, so which right triangle here? One right triangle is there here. This is O. This is O dash. This is P. What is OP, Nana? Capital R minus small r. OP capital R minus small r. What is OO dash? D, distance between centers. From right triangle property, PO dash you can find. PO dash. PO dash square equal to hypotenuse square minus this side square. R minus r whole square. So, PO dash r, AK square, both are same, no? AK. Root over d square minus capital R minus small r whole square. This is the formula to find the length of the direct common tangent. Understood? What is the formula, Nana? Root over distance between their center square minus bracket capital R minus small r square. This is the formula to find the length of the direct common tangent. Similarly, we can construct indirect common tangent also. Okay, length of indirect common tangent formula will get as d square minus capital R plus small r whole square. Capital R plus small r whole square. To construct indirect common tangent, we need to construct a new circle with radius capital R plus small r and center is O dash. We need to construct. That's why your formula will d square minus capital R plus small r whole square. This is the length of indirect common tangent. This is the length of the direct common tangent. By using these two also, we can solve some problems.